Top 10 meals you can try in San Francisco in 48 hours. Hello guys, welcome to FoodBlitz. From San Francisco sourdough to the first Mission burrito, the city by the bay offers a bevy of famous meals that you simply can't experience anywhere else. The city is home to a good sort of flavors focused on savory foods and a healthy mixture of cuisine developed by Chinese immigrants. Chinatown is at the center of the culinary scene in San Francisco and is home to iconic dishes like explosive chicken. Of course, classic Californian cuisine shines within the city with many eggs and bacon included in all kinds of dishes. Seafood is a prominent ingredient also, because of the city's proximity to the shore. So without much further ado, hop into the train as we show you the top 10 meals you can try while in San Francisco in 48 hours. Before we begin, make sure to hit that subscribe button and notification bell below to get more access to videos like this from us. Let's get right into it. Number 10. Chopino. If you would like an iconic San Francisco dish, try Chopino. This rich stew, calamari, Dungeness crab, mussels, and more seafood favorites all married together in a tomato broth, was born in San Francisco's Italian-American community. The art of eating Chopino is an important San Francisco experience. The portions are huge, so it's best to dig in with a bib and large spoon and bread to assist take in a number of the tomato broth once you're through the seafood ingredients. Sadomare is one of the most popular places in town to seek out a sample. Sadomare may have originated the dish, but you can find it in a few other locations in town also, making it a San Francisco favorite. Traditionally the working place of Chinese and Italian immigrants, Fisherman's Wharf is a seafood lover's paradise that reflects its multicultural history. Chopino, an Italian-American seafood stew, was invented to spend the leftover seafood. It soon began cropping abreast of restaurant menus at places like Aliotto's. Today, it is a widely popular dish. Number 9. Dutch Crunch. Eating practically anything on a couple of slices of Dutch crunch bread is amazing. Bakeries everywhere the town pride themselves in their loaves and slices, and with good reason. Roxy Food Center, right outside Balboa Park, may be a simple, no-frills grocery, but its deli has some seriously delicious sandwiches. Anything between a roll of Dutch crunch is a San Francisco must. Dutch crunch is a dense, doughy bread coated in rice flour, yeast, and sugar mixture that's brushed onto the raw dough before baking so that it's infused within the bread. The result is a sweet bread with a crisp, crackling crust that creates a premier choice for sandwiches. Dutch crunch originated in San Francisco, but it's named for the similar Dutch version, which is understood as tiger bread. Check it out while you're in town, as you are not likely to seek out this local favorite outside the Bay Area. Number 8. The Rebel Within. Little muffin hybrids of goodness, the Rebel Within is a savory soft-boiled egg that has found a home inside a sausage muffin. It doesn't get far more San Francisco than that. The geniuses behind this delicious coming together are none aside from craftsmen and wolves within the Mission District. Always served with an itty-bitty bottle of Tabasco sauce, the whole dish is a whole new combat breakfast. The Rebel Within is not any ordinary muffin, because it solidifies the innovative nature of San Francisco cuisine by featuring a sausage muffin with a soft-boiled egg inside. This dish has changed the way many locals believe breakfast, and it's all because of the brilliant minds at Craftsman and Wolves. While the originators are still the simplest place in town to seek out one, you will find similar dishes in additional and more restaurants around town per annum. You can typically tell that your Rebel Within goes well when it's served with some Tabasco sauce. Number 7. Xiao Long Bao. A traditional Chinese steamed soup dumpling, Xiao Long Bao is a surprising staple in San Francisco. These piping hot dumplings are both cooked and served during bamboo steaming baskets, and nobody gets these thin-skinned beauties perfectly cooked like Yangtze within the Embarcadero. Can't get yourself to Shanghai to enjoy this cuisine dish? Then head to the present San Francisco favorite instead. Xiao Long Bao is a popular Chinese steamed bun that has gained serious popularity in San Francisco because of the delicious, piping hot flavors during this soup dumpling. Local Chinese restaurants tend to both cook and serve them in bamboo steaming baskets. As a soup dumpling, this treat differs from typical Chinese dumplings as it contains a soupy substance inside instead of entirely solid ingredients. Mostly, the dumplings are crammed with pork, but you will find variations using seafood and even vegetarian offerings. The key to the present dish is steaming it enough to show the solid meat aspect that's wrapped inside the skin into a soup. Number 6. Carne Asada Burrito. San Francisco's Mission District invented its very own quiet burrito, so not diving into one while within the city should be unlawful. And you can't find a tastier, delightfully greasier and flavorful carne asada burrito than at Taqueria El Farolito. There are a couple of different locations throughout the town, but there's nearly always a line of individuals trying to urge their hungry hands on the Mission burrito. The Mission-style burrito originated in San Francisco's Mission District, an area dominated by Central American culture. Noted for its jumbo proportion, the Mission burrito includes extra rice and other goodies, like sour cream, guacamole, and salsa. Many taquerias serve San Francisco-style burritos within the city. Try El Farolito or Taqueria La Cumbre for a real San Francisco burrito experience. Number 5. Swedish pancakes. For another example of melting pot culture, give Swedish pancakes a try. Yummy, fluffy, and about as big as a silver dollar. Swedish pancakes are a San Francisco breakfast dish loved by many. Since 1938, Sears Fine Food has been serving the town from morning till night, with a whopping 18 Swedish pancakes in an order. Number 4. Egg custard tart. The egg custard tart features a pastry crust that's crammed with an egg custard that is sweet, flaky, creamy, buttery, everything San Franciscans want in a dessert, and it is a staple of Chinatown. The favored dish features a sweet flavor and was delivered to San Francisco by immigrants from the Hong Kong area. You can find these treats in bakeries all across town, but the Chinatown Golden Gate Bakery is the hottest place to get them. Number 3. Hangtown Fry. The Hangtown Fry is an omelet first invented during the gold rush of the 1850s that expertly mixes eggs, bacon, and the special ingredient, which are oysters. When the dish was first introduced, oysters were an expensive ingredient, so this humble omelet by modern standards was once a symbol of success. Only miners who struck gold could afford this $6 meal, which is the equivalent of $200 today. Fortunately, you'll find Hangtown Fry everywhere in the town lately in diners and restaurants of multiple kinds, many of which put their spin thereon. As long as you're an oyster lover, you're bound to enjoy it. Number 2. Crab Louie. Crab Louie is a popular San Francisco salad that features crab meat and typically includes hard-boiled eggs, tomato, asparagus, crisped lettuce, and Louie dressing. Louie dressing is an important ingredient for this salad because its combination of mayonnaise and chili sauce gives the salad its signature taste. You can find variations of this salad around town that use ingredients like olives and spring onions. You can also try the lobster Louie, which, because the name suggests, replaces the crab meat with lobster. Number 1. Explosive Chicken. Explosive chicken isn't a dish to be taken lightly, as it's an Asian-style crispy chicken dish that's full of many Sichuan chili peppers for a few serious bites. This dish originated from Z and Y restaurant in San Francisco and combines American love for crispy chicken, traditional Chinese cooking, and hot chili peppers to make something new and powerful. Mind you, this dish isn't designed to easily be a mouthful of warmth, which might be too easy. Instead, each ingredient from the chicken itself to the peppers is carefully cooked, measured, and seasoned to maximize flavor in particular else. And that's it for today, guys. Did these meals make you salivate? And what are you waiting for? Get on your horses and start planning for your next vacation to be in San Francisco, or if you are already there and you haven't tried these meals out, then I advise you to step out there and treat yourself to some of them. Till then, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click the notification bell to get more videos like this for your trips. Thanks for watching, see you guys soon.